Hi friends, welcome to First Studies YouTube channel. This is part 35 in Azure Synapse Analytics playlist. So in this video we are going to discuss about this percentage run. This is a magic command which you can use to reference another notebook within your current notebook. That means, for example, if you have notebook 1 and if you have notebook 2, from notebook 2 if you want to refer notebook 1 and execute the notebook 1, then how to do that? So for that we can use this percentage run magic command actually, and I am going to practically show you that as well. So the agenda also the same thing, right? As I mentioned, referencing another notebook within your current notebook using the run magic command. So this is how you write. You use this run syntax and then you will be providing a path of your notebook to execute your notebook inside your current notebook actually. And also, not only this run command and the path, you can pass any parameters also if that another notebook has. I will show you that, I will explain you that in practically also. So let me go to my Synapse workspace. So this is my Synapse workspace. So here, let me go to development menu to create a new notebook. So let me create a new notebook here, and let me name my notebook as maybe like, okay, let it be notebook one. Okay, notebook one is my notebook. So here, let's assume I have a variable like this, maybe name. If you see here, you need to kind of attach your notebook with a SQL, the Spark pool with which you want to execute. And also you can select the default language also. So here what I am going to use, I am going to use a name variable in Python. So I am writing a Python code here. Why? Because the default language here I selected is Python, right? PySpark, okay. So let's assume here I have a name called Mahir. And then below I am simply printing it, okay. So maybe I want to print like hello, then space, then what is the value inside that variable name, right? So I want to print like hello Mahir. So if I run this notebook, this is going to print hello Mahir actually. Let me practically show you that also. So to run a I hit this run shell button here. This is going to start the Spark session first, and once the session started, it is going to print the message saying hello Mahir. Why? Because this name variable contains value Mahir. So let's wait for the session to start here. Great. Spark session started, and see, it printed hello Mahir message here. So let's assume this is my notebook one. So let me publish this. So that means let's assume you have this notebook one, and in future you want to run this notebook one from another notebook using the run command. So that is what I am going to show you now. So I hit this publish button to publish this notebook one. We have to make sure, before referencing any notebook in another notebook, you should make sure that particular notebook is published actually. So notebook one is published successfully. Now let me create another notebook here, and this notebook name is, let me keep maybe notebook two. So let me change the name of my notebook to notebook two. And from this notebook two, I want to refer this notebook one actually. So let me stop this parse session which is there inside this notebook one for a time being, and then let me go here. So here, from here, from this notebook 2, I want to run this notebook 1, right? So for that, you can use this run magic command, okay? And then here, you need to provide a path, okay? So path will always start with this forward slash, but here, I don't have any folders. For example, if I have here a folder called ABCD, and inside that folder, if I have notebook 1, then I should type like this, ABCD, then notebook 1, okay? But in my case, I don't have any folders. Notebook is directly available here, right? So that means my path will become directly slash notebook. So if I execute this command now inside this notebook, then it is going to refer this notebook one, and it is actually going to execute this code. Let me practically show you that. So let me attach a Spark pool for this notebook, which is notebook two, and default language is Python only, and I have written this command already. So let me hit this run shell button to actually execute this shell, which is in turn going to execute my notebook, and let's see whether we will able to print the results of notebook one again the same thing like hello Mahir. Let's wait and see that for it. So it looks my session is ready now. So in next few seconds, it is going to execute my notebook one, and it is actually going to print the results also. See here, it printed hello Mahir. That means it actually executed this notebook one. Okay. So now, not only this, so if you see the slide, let me go to the presentation. If you see here, not only this path, you can pass the parameters also along with it. And at this moment, you can pass int type parameters, float type parameters, boolean type, and string type. But you might be wondering, what is this parameters, why we have to pass all this? So for your quick understanding, let me explain you. For example, in this example, let's assume here I hard coded the value called Mahir here. So whenever you run this notebook, it is always going to print hello Mahir only. What if I parameterize this particular notebook? That means whatever the value I pass in this name variable from the parameters from another notebook, that value it should take and it should print the result accordingly. If I pass here value as Wafa, then it should take Wafa and print hello Wafa. Okay, if I pass value here as Mahir, then it will take Mahir and it will print hello Mahir. So for that, actually you need to make sure to parameterize this notebook one first and then try to pass that parameters from the run command. So how to parameterize this notebook, I am going to explain in our next video. So for in this video, for example, let's assume here you already parameterized this. That means this name variable, whatever you see here, it is parameterized. Then how to pass that value into that notebook one is, so you need to use this dictionary syntax here and you need to use key value pairs. For example, if I have a parameter called name in my notebook one, then I should use name as a key there and I should pass whatever the value. So I can pass maybe Wafa. So if there is a parameter with this name inside my notebook one, then for that parameter I am supplying Wafa here. So according to that, it will pass the values into notebook one. It will execute the notebook one. Okay, so that's how actually logic works. So this is the full syntax of the run command. Percentage run, then your notebook path, then if that particular notebook has any parameters, supply that parameters as a key value pairs. Okay, and how to parameterize any notebook, as I said, I will be explaining that in our upcoming video. Okay, so now let me go to presentation. So that's it in this video. So I want to explain you like how to use this run command in a high level. I hope you got this idea. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification whenever I add videos. Thank you so much.